Thank you very much.
I know you're leaving.
And so click with me, www.memory.com. And the very first that pops up is how Nigeria traveled to Holland and got a coach. The one who today they call the Dutch Gerrard. He could speak a passable English when he came to Nigeria, but today he's almost perfect speaking the Queen's language. And I recall how some of us met him on his way to Dodan Barracks when he was still very young, in office as the coach of the national team of Nigeria, the Super Eagles. And he told us there and then, this moment, Missy Vice President. He couldn't really speak good English then. Clemens Westerhoff.
I'll be waiting for you.
Really got a lot of support from then, a number two man.
If you feel
Aihomo. Great Admiral Aihomo.
www.memory.
There was a problem between him and the FA at that time.
Like
things were not moving the way he expected. And he journeyed to Dodan Barracks.
www.memory.
And as he was going, I told us at this moment, Missy Vice President. He got his support. I hit us www.memory.com again. Another story pops up. 1994. Nigeria.
You're leaving.
In the USA for the very first time in the World Cup final.
Walk out on this
the boys came out for a game against Bulgaria.
You'll never call.
And jerseys looked like t-shirts they buy in the open market.
You made
many colors, many colors.
You're gone.
Not the traditional kind of jersey. The match started, and I remember this.
www.memory.
How Nigeria's first goal was scored.
Waiting for you.
And as the ball sailed into the net, the scorer himself ran in. And so the ball hit the net, and the scorer held the net.
www.memory.
Oh, www.memory this day. And he started saying very many things. Some said he was just giving thanks to God Almighty. Some said he was calling his name. What was he saying then? But we called him Ganglin. Rashidi Yekini.
You can tell me that you love.
Yes, I can tell another one. Even as I hit www.memory.com.
Touch me.
And another story this morning that comes up is how Finidi George gave them a special dance in the USA.
www.memory.
He scored and put all fours on the field. The knees on the field, the hands are on the field, and raised at the right leg.
www.memory.
Yeah, you are now punching your own, huh? www.memory.
Click on me.
Click, 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 click.
www.memory.
And we called it the Crawler's Dance. The one Finidi George introduced to the world. Crawler's Dance. In a World Cup final. Oh, who would ever forget the dance?
You'll never call.
By Dan the Bull Amokachi, his own kind of Makosa. It was in the game Nigeria against Bulgaria. And when the powerful one, Dan the Bull, scored, he gave them Makosa. Land in Africa, perfected in the city of Liverpool, where Everton plays.
If you feel the need, just click on me at www.memory.
Yes, and I click again, and what appears? The dance of Amuneke and Iruha. So joyous, Iruha did not know the full weight of Imanuel Amuneke as he backed him in jubilation. With him map pointing and thanking God. You've done it for Nigeria.
www.memory.
www.memory.
I'll be waiting.
And I recall the game Nigeria Italy. 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 2 minutes. Just like it happened in the game Nigeria Tunisia and Abuja.
www.memory.
Some of us were already saying the Eagles have won and have qualified for the next round. And our coach started shouting, Arigo! He was called. Scream the name of Baggio, Baggio, Baggio! He didn't add the word save my job. That was what he meant. Baggio, Baggio, Baggio! And our coach did not scream. Eguavoen, be more experienced, show more maturity. And it was a penalty against Nigeria. And Baggio did not miss from the spot. But before that, was a story of a guy who did so well in 1986. Scored the hand of God goal and played against Nigeria for Argentina. Oh, memories. Diego Maradona against Nigeria. We saw a man. Doctors later saw a cocktail of drugs in his system. His jogging was just too much. Very, very abnormal. The scene was already working. And I click again. My personal notes this time. And I recall how I stayed awake from 3 a.m. when CNN flashed the story that Maradona had been caught, had tested positive for the use of ephedrine and other drugs in the game of Nigeria against Argentina. 3 a.m. I got the story and rushed. Thank God for grace. Drove very fast to Abeokuta that morning to give the story out on Bonvita Sports Special.
I'll be waiting for you.
I remember the program the day after Nigeria was sacked by Italy. And the song, The Lights Went Out in Massachusetts. Oh, The Lights Went Out in Massachusetts. And we now move to 1998. I recall that in the press center of the Saint Denis Stadium in the city of Paris, Nigerian sports writers were told that we were going to be crushed by Spain. A great team by all standards are going into the World Cup 1998. Andoni Zubizarreta, super goalkeeper for Spain at that time, with Fernando Hierro and Nadal. Strong defenders of great grace at that time. In front of the Nigerian attackers. And the ball has strayed to the pass of Sunday Olise. And with the right leg, the most perfect of shots.
You'll never call me.
2-2 it was before that time. And Nigeria defeated Spain 3-2. What a great press conference it was. Post-match conference, I tell you. And we all attended, showing off anything green and white. We are told in hospitals that people get screened. Ikpeba introduced it to the Eagles play back in 1998. When he screened a defender and talked a low ball under the arms of our goalkeeper. Yes, Nigeria, Bulgaria, you recall. And we called him headmaster going to the World Cup final. Mutiu Adekwaju. A throw in, and with the head, the headmaster proved himself. Scored for Nigeria. What about the surprise goal? The goal that even surprised the scorer.
You made your mind up.
Think. Click now. www.memory.
If some rain.
Yes, Gabalawa's goal, you remember?
www.memory.
Little effort. Great result.
www.memory.
And I recall how we tried to get into the Eagles camp in Paris, France to resolve the differences between the Eagles and the FA officials at that time, just before we played Denmark. Security guards wouldn't allow us in, and so we had to return to our hotel. And 30 minutes after the game, told this story many times over. Commentators of the BBC saw me and said, "You are a Nigerian, come and talk to us about this match. Do you think Nigeria will win?" And I told them, "Our players are already thinking of the game against Brazil." Because in all the interviews conducted before that game, players told us they were looking forward to the game Nigeria-Brazil and not even the game Nigeria-Denmark, because Denmark was going to be whitewashed.
www.memories.
And oh, memories, I tell you.
If you feel like love, just
after the game,
call me.
Lamentation.
www.memories.
Despair. Frustration. Deep pain. That was the night Peter Refai gave us the words that we'll never forget. Players were already thinking of the game Nigeria-Brazil before crossing the hurdle called at Denmark. Austin Okocha played in that game.
The game against Denmark, we lost that game due to lack of concentration, you know, because we were playing so well that we thought, oh, Denmark will be an easy game, and we started thinking of playing Brazil because it could have been Brazil next after Denmark.
I told the BBC Nigeria was going to whitewash Denmark. And after the game, I saw they were looking. Memories. I saw they were looking in my direction. And I took a duck. Tell my story. I took a duck. I click again. And stories about the year 2002. Nigeria, Sweden. A good pull out by Yobo Joseph. And at the head of Julius Efosa Howa connected. And as he saw the ball entering the net, he too decided to give the world what they will never forget. One flip, two, three, four, five. Oh! Even the commentator screamed.
Yobo. Oh, lovely ball in. Oh, it's one of the classic goals in the World Cup. What a super goal that is, and here we go, Agahoa, on and on and on, woo!
www.
Exactly what the commentator said then.
If you feel the need, just click on me.
Memories.
www.memories.
Of Ogbeche. At that World Cup. And how he was selected. Remember the flip in that friendly game. Oh, memories. Memories too of what some of the players said. How they ran in the cold at 7 a.m. in training.
Look into my eyes.
Running in the snow.
Tell me that you love.
It's 7 o'clock. We should be training at 7.
No, you won't have to touch me or even take my hand. Just slide your little mouth.
World Cup training.
Till you see it land.
Back your man, wrong.
www.memories. I'll be waiting for you.
Oh, 2002 memories, I tell you. How terrible West has spilled blood because of Nigeria.
When we are coming to play, we know what it means to burn your jersey and burn your body. I got injured for your team, for your country, and for your people.
So you don't find bandages only in hospitals.
Like love.
Ask terrible West, he will tell you. Memories, sir.
www.memories.
2006, we were not there. But thanks to the Emirates Airline, got out of that World Cup Germany 2006. And became an analyst. Because so many kept asking the question, why did Nigeria not qualify? What happened? Memories! How my food got cold, telling some Germans why we could not qualify for the World Cup.
You feel like talking, you
memories.
Lock me home.
How we saw ourselves supporting Ghana.
www.memories.
Because if your country did not qualify, you won't associate with the country near yours.
If you feel
and how we supported Ghana. Oh, how we supported Ghana. Up Ghana, up Ghana.
www.memories.
By now.
www.memories. I'll be